In today's video, I want to share with you how you can use a combination of validation rules, conditional logic, as well as formula fields to ensure that signers can't make an error when they complete the envelope. One of the reasons, and probably the most important reason, I believe financial advisors must use DocuSign to collect signatures on their documents and information, is because DocuSign really gives you powerful tools. I mean, can be configured with advanced logic to make sure that your signers don't enter information that's invalid in the documents, or that the documents don't come back with missing signatures. And other electronic signature softwares out there don't have the same capabilities. It might be great for just collecting signatures, but really DocuSign is the one that's going to eliminate all that back and forth between your internal team and the clients. So in today's video, I want to share with you how you can use a combination of validation rules, conditional logic, as well as formula fields to ensure that signers can't make an error when they complete the envelope. And so in this example, I'm going to use this beneficiary nomination form. If you send this form by email, it's a total disaster because signers are going to make a ton of errors. You're going to have to follow up with them and tell them, hey, this field is wrong, you need to fix it. So it's just a complete pain in the ass. Let's just call it for what it is. And if you're new to the channel, my name is Sofiane Saoudi and I'm the founder of SoluSign Consulting. I help financial advisors automate document workflows and use electronic signature solutions such as DocuSign eSignature to prevent signers from entering errors in forms and just automate all that compliance and boring paperwork. So if you're interested in getting more help than just a YouTube video, you can book a strategy call with me using the link in the description just down below. But so for those who haven't seen this form, what is this? So it's a beneficiary election form. So there's two types of beneficiaries signers can nominate: primary and contingent beneficiaries. There can be a number of up to four primary beneficiaries, so 25% each, and signers can also nominate contingent beneficiaries. Now, there can only be up to three contingent beneficiaries because the total, the maximum total number of primary beneficiaries is four, and you can't have four contingent beneficiaries. You must have at least one primary before you can have contingent. And so since the total beneficiaries has to be four, you can have one primary beneficiaries or and three contingent. You could also have two primary and two contingent. You could have three primaries and one contingent. It doesn't matter what the mix is. The thing is that for every type of beneficiaries, so for all primary beneficiaries, the total must add up to 100%, and it's the same thing for contingent. The total must add up to 100%. And if that's not the case, we want signers to see an error message, and also we want to make sure that they can't submit the form. That's the most important thing. So we can use conditional logic and formula fields to do that. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is we want to give a radio button for primary and contingent beneficiaries, and we are going to rename our replayable. Then I'm going to rename the values. So the first field, the first option is primary, and the second is a contingent beneficiary. Then I'm going to add my benefit percentage, and I'm also going to call this one B1 benefit percentage. And I'm going to validate this with numbers only. Now let's just do the same thing for our second beneficiary. So if I highlight all the fields and do Command D, that copies everything over. Before I rename all my fields, I'm going to change the rules for those, for all those fields. I want to make them optional because some signers might only want to nominate one person, so there's no need for me to force them to enter other beneficiaries if they only want to nominate one person. Normally what you would want to do, the best practice, is to rename all the fields, but just for the demo, I'm not going to bother renaming the labels for all my addresses and the names, but I'm certainly going to do it for my radio buttons and my benefit percentages. Now the tricky part is going to be to validate the total percentage. There is no way for me to build a formula field that will check whether the number entered in the benefit percentage is linked to a primary or contingent. So there is no way that I can actually use the same field to do the calculation that will prevent signers from entering numbers that don't add up to 100% for primaries and contingent signers and contingent beneficiaries. So what I need to do is actually use two different fields for my second, third, and fourth beneficiary. And you will understand how this is gonna work. So what I'm gonna do is just reduce the width of those fields and duplicate them, and then I'm gonna put them here. And so now I'm going to rename this field. So this one is gonna be B2 primary, because we've already got first primary here. So this one is gonna be the second primary. This one is gonna be the third primary, and this one is gonna be the fourth primary. And you need to get rid of all the clutter that's there. Now I'll do the same thing for my other column. So for my contingent beneficiaries, so for this one, I'm gonna call it B1 benefit contingent, and rename all the other ones with B2 and B3. Now what I need to do is I want my signers to enter information in this field if primary is selected, or in this field if contingent is selected. So now I need to set up my first round of conditional logic. So I'm gonna click on my trigger here, my radio button group, and select primary, and then this particular text field. And then I'm gonna do an action, and then I'm gonna do the same thing with the contingent. Select contingent and select this field. And by the way, those ones shouldn't be optional, they should be required. But they are only required once these fields are set up or selected. And actually, we're going to make these ones required also, but they are only going to show up once somebody starts entering a name in the name of the beneficiary. And actually, I'm going to do this quickly for all the other ones. Okay, that's done. So now let's just test that my logic is working. Okay, so theoretically I can enter if I start entering something here, then all the other fields will pop up. So let's just go with Bob. Okay, and so if I select primary recipient, then I can enter a number in this field. And if it's contingent, then it's this field. Let's test the rest. Yes. Perfect, it works. So now I can go ahead and build the rest of the logic. So I'm gonna add my first formula field that I'm gonna call 100% total validation for primary. And then I'm gonna set up the rule. And in my formula, I'm going to reference all my total, I'm gonna reference all my benefit percentage fields that only apply to the primary signer. And actually I've just realized that we don't need a contingent option for the first beneficiary, because we know it's going to be a primary. This is an error maybe in the form, because we know we're gonna have one primary beneficiary at least. So let's just start by this one. So back to the formula field. Now that I've got it here, I'm going to set it up and I'm going to include all my benefit percentage fields for my primary recipients, and tell DocuSign that they must add up to 100%. So I'm going to insert my B1 benefit percentage plus my B2 plus my B3 equals 100. I'm asking DocuSign whether my statement in my formula is true. So I'm stating something, I'm saying that all these fields equal to 100. If it's true, DocuSign will return a value that's 1, so it will print a number 1 here. And if it's not true, it will print a number which is 0. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to tell DocuSign what to do if this is true and what to do if it's not true. So if the formula is not true, I want to display an error message. And so I can just add my error message here and make this in red and bold and 14 and scary. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to call this field error message, and I'm going to add a validation and call and choose a custom validation and put whatever in this. So by doing this, I'm just telling DocuSign that recipients must enter exactly this in the field, but they don't know what they need to enter. So this is the way that you stop people from finishing the form, is by adding a validation that they would never be able to guess in a field that you make required, so that people can't actually proceed and go ahead and sign. Now I only want this rule to kick in if my formula is returning a value zero, meaning that the statement here that all my beneficiaries add up to 100% is true or untrue. So I'm going to say that if my formula is untrue, is not true, then which means it's a zero in DocuSign language, then I'm going to display this thing. I'm going to do the same thing for my contingent beneficiaries. I'm going to add another formula field. And by the way, we don't want the formula to show. So what you do is you make them white. So for the data label for this field, I'm just gonna copy this here and paste it in there and change this to contingent. And I'm essentially going to do the same thing, but only referencing my three potential contingent beneficiaries. So beneficiary one plus the second contingent plus the third equals 100, and save. Now this is just stressing me out because it's bigger than that, so I'm going to fix that up. So now I've just copied this particular field and I'm going to make it conditional to my contingent formula. So if my formula is not true, then I want this to kick in. Perfect. And I can actually overlay them. And the only way you can test envelopes with formula fields is by sending the actual envelope, because the formula fields don't work in the recipient preview, which is kind of annoying. So now if I enter a benefit percentage here that's less than 50, my error message still shows up. Now if I test this and enter 100, normally my field should disappear. But it doesn't. I can't really see because I've overlaid the two different text fields, but one of the formula fields doesn't work. And it's because of a conditional logic that I've missed. So let's go back in the template and fix it. I'm just going to split the error message one more time, actually going backwards here, because I want to be able to see which error message is coming up when it should not, actually. So I'm gonna add a C and a P. So C for contingent and P for primary. The problem is that we have this particular formula here that's meant to prevent signers from not entering numbers that add up to 100% for contingent beneficiaries. But the problem is that we don't know for sure that signers are gonna want to add contingent beneficiaries. So what we need to do is we need to make this formula conditional to whether one contingent beneficiary is added to the document or not. And so the way we do this is by making this formula conditional to one of those radio buttons. But which one should we choose for the condition? And the way you create a multi-conditional condition is by using another formula field combined with other text fields. So what we're gonna do here is add other text fields, and we're gonna add them in white because we don't want them to show on the document. I'm going to enter a number one inside of my field, and then I'm going to hide this field by making it read-only and not required. And I'm going to call this, and I'm going to change the label to contingent one selected. And then I'm going to duplicate this field, put it here, and duplicate this field and put it here as well. And so for this one, I'm going to call it, contingent 2 selected, and then this one, contingent 3 selected. Now I'm going to make these text fields conditional to this, to whether the Rager button contingent is selected for each contingent beneficiary. So I'm going to select contingent and select this one, and then I'm going to select my second contingent and select this field, and then I'm going to select my third contingent and select this field. So now what's going to happen is that if a signer clicks on contingent, then the number one will appear. Then number one will appear here, and then number one will appear here. This is something that I can use in a formula to create another condition. So I'm going to add my other formula field, and I'm going to call it if contingent is selected. And it's also in white, so people can't see it. And I'm going to set up my rule and say that my contingent 1 plus my contingent 2 plus my contingent 3 selected is greater than 0. And the reason I'm saying greater than 0 is because there could be more than one selected, and if there are more than one selected, well, it's going to be 1 plus 1 plus 1, potentially 3. But if the total is 0, then I know that all the beneficiaries are primary beneficiaries and not contingent, and therefore I don't want my formula to kick in. Okay, so now my formula is going to return a value whether it's true or not. If my statement, which is all these fields are greater than 0, is true, then it's a 1. So then I want to tell DocuSign what to do if this is true. And so if this is true, I want to trigger the formula field, the other formula field, which is going to check whether all the contingent beneficiary percentages add up to 100%. So I'm going to select my trigger, create my rule, and say that if my rule is true, meaning if the total is greater than 1, then I want to make this particular formula field here for my contingent beneficiaries to kick in. All right, so I'm gonna save and close and test it again. So for now, we have our error message, and that's normal because we haven't entered anything in this benefit percentage field, which is required. So I'm gonna add the first participant as being myself, let's just say, and I'm gonna give myself 50%. The message should stay. Now I'm gonna add another beneficiary, and I'm gonna make this one Eva, and I'm gonna say that this is a primary beneficiary, and I give her 30%. The message should stay, and it stays. Now if I add another beneficiary, Bob, and I make it primary, so I've got a delta of 20%. So if I add a 20%, then my error message should disappear, and it does. Now if I add another beneficiary, and I call it Danielle, then if I select that it's a contingent beneficiary, then for now I've got my error message, and that's normal because the percentage doesn't add up to 100% yet. But if I do 100, then it disappears. If I do 90, it's here. And if I change my mind and want to make this particular person a contingent rather than a primary, then I messed everything up, right? I've got the two error messages. So now I need to have 100% for contingent. I've already got 90 here, so this one should be a 10, and the error message will disappear. And so for this one, I need to change this one to 50, and it should disappear. And there you go. And this is how you make sure that your beneficiary forms don't come back with errors in your forms.
If you need more help with DocuSign and want an expert to assist you with your DocuSign implementation, you can find the link to book a strategy call with me in the description of this video, and I will speak to you in the next one.